pleasure to be here. And I would like to present some of the works that we have done at the National Observatory for Human Development in Morocco. And especially the use we did of MPI in the evaluation of a specific program, which called the National Initiative for Human Development. Our observatory is an institution, independent institution, created by the King of Morocco, and which aims to evaluate, assess the government policies in human development. So it means that we have financial independence, but also an autonomy. And we are asked to be transparent, and all our works are public. So that is very important. So we start from scratch. So we were obliged to build tools. And here I will give some examples of the tools that we have developed since 2008. The first of them, we have to have an information system. It's very important to have an information system to gather all the information that's produced in the country from all the departments, but also the information coming from international organizations and the United Nations. So you have here some elements of the database that we call Al-Bashariya. Al-Bashariya in Arabic means the population. And it gives us a set of data with 600 statistical series, 400 indicators, and we have also for benchmarking 120 countries for which we have 130 indicators that we can compare. The second thing that we have seen very important to us is to implement a panel of households. Why? Because what is important when talking about poverty is to follow the dynamic of the poverty. How the people and why the people go for vulnerability to poverty, for example. That is very important. Why, in fact, even if you invest in education, you don't have the expected result, and why perhaps there is some kind of effect of education, health, and so on, and vice versa. That is very important. The dynamic is important. So 8,000 households for the time being, about 20,000 individuals, and we are expanding the sample to 16,000 households and about 80,000 individuals. That means that we have a huge quantities of information and the possibility of looking to the dynamic of evolution, and that is very important. And of course we introduce different techniques that are the theories from individual behaviors. It appears to us that it is very important to have information about what is going on in behavior when implement some policies. The reason is the culture of the people is very important. So how do they behave before and after you implement the program? And why does it change on the social capital, for example? And that is also something important that we try to assess. Here, talking about this initiative, National Initiative for Human Development, initiative that was aimed to address poverty in rural area and exclusion in the cities. Why? Because the problem in the cities is not poverty, it's exclusion. And exclusion, of course, can give some aspects of poverty in the cities. So this program is the first phase of the program was about 1 billion euro. And the implementation program was at the local level. It means that at the local level, civil society, elected people, and the local government are asked to propose projects. And this project, so there is a committee, local committee, who decide for this project, and the projects are led or by association or by individuals. So the issue there was to measure the effects of this initiative 5 years after its implementation. It's exactly what we did here. So you can have here the comparison between 2008 and 2011 for urban and for rural areas. And we took all the dimensions of the MPI. That's what we did. So you can see that there is improvement over there. There is serious improvement in the different dimensions for some of them more than others, but globally there is improvement. But what does it mean? That the effects that we have here are consequent to the initiative, or are they just because there is some other actions that led to this result? So we have to make another kind of study, which is based on the RDD, the regression discontinuity design. And here you have an example for the income. When we see with the threshold of 30% of the poverty, you have a jump. That means that it's really due to this, because it was the variable that in fact is different between the targeted and non-targeted counties or pointers. So what is important here to say is that first, that there is effect on income, for example, but not on the children's health. There is impact on the health of the parents, but not the children, for example. That is very important information. So we saw that social capital, for example, improved in some way. For example, sharing program, working together, improved. But risk-taking didn't improve, for example. So you have just the possibility to see exactly what is happening. So now, what is important for us in the future is to go beyond all of this and try to understand the mechanism. And for that, I think networking is something very important. And it doesn't move anyway. Well, networking is very important. So we developed many, many partnerships. And one of the most important that we have is with Conibail. So we are working together now for more than 2 years. We have specific projects that we are doing and taking together, and it's very important for us. At the same time, we are looking to use the methods that are developed for OFI for using them for measuring the effects of human development, not only the poverty. And that is important because we have to introduce other dimensions, and especially the individual innovation, like, for example, capabilities and things like that. So that's one example of what we have been doing so far. Thank you very much.